know, I had this funny question. Maybe it's a dilemma. I don't know. You know, as a kid, I grew up thinking that forest was a safe place, and there's no such thing as no. There's no bears out in the forest, no wolves in the forest, all that kind of stuff. Although there are moose in the forest. I haven't seen one this year, but it was spotted and it's on the radio saying, oh, people out in this area, watch out for the moose. So I'm watching out for the moose. But anyway, you know, now as an adult, I grew up thinking everything was peachy keen and fine. But I find myself thinking, you know, like, is the forest really a safe place to be? You know, I've captured coyotes out here on videotape. Just last week, I was out here cutting firewood, and there was coyotes right almost where I am right now, running around. Got them on tape, but you know, they're a little bit fuzzy because they're kind of far away. But yeah, there were coyotes. I know coyotes come and go, but you know, we don't have any bears here. And in our town last year, there was animals going missing, and I don't recall what month that was. It was in the summertime, and it's happening again this year. Maybe not as noticeably as it was last year, but I've seen a little advertisement up in the grocery store as usual, and the post office, saying keep your animals, keep an eye on them, basically, because someone or something or some group of people is coming around and taking your animals and possibly selling them for, you know, university animal research. Okay, that's a creative way to look at it. A better way to look at it is that we have something living right here in the forest who's walking into town, because right now there is no great source of food. You got the wheat fields, but you know, I think it takes more than just handful after handful of wheat if you're a large creature out here. The corn's not on yet, the berries aren't ripened, and why not grab a crispy, crunchy dog across the highway here? It's coming. So, I find myself reflecting on this a lot. You know, our kids ride on this fire trail all the way out to the forest, and they have been for a long time. My 23-year-old son used to ride out here all the time with his little brother, who's now 14, and we didn't think anything of it. I'm always looking back too, but I'll be darned if I let my kids now right out here, because there's a lot of unexpected, maybe unexplainable things that seem to be happening around here. And it just sounds crazy if I get into it, because for one, I don't want to look crazy. I already look crazy enough out here looking for Bigfoot. And if anybody came along and said, what are you doing out here with the camera? I'm a bird watcher. Don't know the first thing about birds, but I'm a bird watcher. Yes, sir. It's It's a really weird world we've created for ourselves, and we grew up reassuring ourselves that everything in the world is in our little world for each one of us. It's a safe environment. We like to believe that. But you won't find too many people who will walk through the forest even though it's a safe environment and there is no bears, and we have the occasional moose here. Nobody will venture into the forest. Nobody. Including me. Unless I have some friends with me and we got some lighting and all that, or some way to see in the dark. I'd love to be able to see in the dark. Then I would go out there. With a thermal imager, or going out in the dark would become an adventure then. Without that stuff, I hate to tell you, Mom, it's not a safe environment out here. Like I've said before, the signs are all around us. The evidence is everywhere. We just gotta be clever enough to find it and know it for what it is. Anyway, I've gone on talking about how unsafe the forest is long enough. Timber giant Bigfoot. Once we crash, then it will be more new videos for like another 2 months. Anyway, see you later.